Good morning, Vandal. Today I am going to summarize inline filter design. It has considered Butterworth low pass filter, magnitude of frequency response of the system. See mod h of j omega, where omega is in radians per second, omega equals to 2 pi f, f is in hertz, omega is in radians per second. Here the unknown parameters in this are capital omega c and n. N is order of the filter. N is order of the filter. Omega c is the 3 dB grid of frequency. You can look into this filter. Is a frequency versus gain. Let's look into this blue color one. This is second order filter. N equals to 2. This is monotonically decreasing, right? Gain is monotonically decreasing. For the Butterworth low pass filters, the gain will be monotonically decreasing with frequency. If the frequency is increasing, the gain keeps on decreasing, right? Monotonically decreasing. Same behavior for others also. This is third order filter. This is fifth order filter. Yeah, the order of the filter keeps on increasing. What's happening is, in the pass band, the gain is approaching to 1. In the stop band, the gain is approaching to 0, right? It's trying to approach to ideal filter. If the order of the filter keeps on increasing. But the problem you are going to get is, if the order of the filter keeps on increasing, the required number of RLC components also will be high. That is proportional to order of the filter. Then the size of the circuit also will be high, right? The cost will be high. It means you should try to get the trade-off between cost and efficiency. Some applications you can tolerate up to some level, right? It depends on the application. No need to maintain always ideal filter characteristics. It depends on application. You can try to tolerate up to some level. Here the filter specifications. This delta P equals to 0.9 head. This is a minimum required pass band gain. And delta S equal to 0.1 head. This is a maximum allowed stop band gain. Maximum allowed stop band gain. That means in the stop band, gain should be less than or equal to 0.1. Or gain should be less than or equal to delta S. In the pass band, gain should be greater than or equal to delta P, right? It means you can say 0 to FP is the pass band. You can see 0 to FP interval. This is always greater than or equal to delta P, right? This gain. And FS2 beyond that one, the gain is always less than or equal to delta S, right? So we can call it like stop band, and you can call this like pass band. Up to this, this is pass band. 0 to FP is the pass band, and beyond FS is the stop band. Between FP and FS, you can call it like transition band. The transition from pass band to stop band. The transition band. In general, it's better to maintain narrow transition band. Narrow transition band means the stop band cutoff frequency is somewhere nearby this one. That will be good compared to this one. Always narrow transition band is better one. Transition band should be as narrow as possible. But if you want to make transition band to be narrow, the design also will be a bit complex. It's not so easy. Sometimes you may need to go for higher order filter also. This is in the Laplace domain. This is a transfer function of Butterworth low pass filter. Here the unknown things for us are n. N is the order of the filter and omega c, 3 dB grid of frequency. These are the unknown things for us. Let's look into specifications of a low pass filter. in general, people will try to give these specifications. They'll try to give these specifications and they'll try to ask you, can you design a filter for me? That's what they'll do. The other specifications. See, passband specification. Delta P is the minimum required passband gain or minimum required passband gain, and this is the passband cutoff frequency. It means that from 0 to omega P, we required at least delta P gain. The other stopband specifications, beyond omega S, the gain of the filter should be less than or equal to delta S. Butterworth filter frequency response. The only unknown things in this expression are omega C and N. If you are able to find what is N, what is omega C, we are done with our design. Because once you know what is N, what is omega C, then you can simply have this transfer function, right? You can substitute N and omega C into this expression and you can try to have your transfer function straight away. Once you know the transfer function, you can design filter, right? At least in network theory, while doing network synthesis, you might heard about this, right? If you know the transfer function, you can try to design a circuit. By using this expression, you can try to find the order of the filter. Here we are going for seal, right? Seal of N. The reason for this one is this expression need not be integer always. For example, if this is equal to 3.1, we required integer, right? Order of the filter should be integer, N should be integer. Then we'll try to convert this to 4. If you are 3.1, we'll try to make it like 4. Seal, right? Floor of 3.1 means 3. Seal of 3.1 means 4. We'll try to go for upper round off. If you got 3, there is no problem at all. If this is just integer, 3 means NB will be same as 3 only. If that is 3.1, we'll try to round off to 4. It means we are not considering the exact N value, right? Because N can be some fraction. We are trying to do some sealing operation, right? That means some modification we are doing for our actual design. It means that some of the specifications we may need to modify, right? Or that should be in good manner. Good manner means we'll try to maintain the passband requirements as it is. That means we'll try to maintain at least delta P gain in the passband, that we'll try to maintain. But what we are going to modify is we'll try to decrease the stopband cutoff frequency. That's good for you, right? Decreasing stopband cutoff frequency. Let's have a look into this one. If you try to maintain the same passband specifications, once you do sealing operation, that means in the passband you are maintaining a gain of at least 0.9 up to MP. There is no problem. But what we are saying is this stopband cutoff frequency might be less compared to earlier one. For example, if this FS shifted to 8 kilohertz instead of 9 kilohertz, 9 kilohertz instead of 9, if this is 8, what's happening is this curve will be going down, right? This is intercept at this point. Up to this, this is almost same. Above 0.9 gain. And up, after that, what's happening is this will come something like this. And this will try to intersect at 8 at this point. It means your transition band is becoming narrow, right? That is good for you. Passband specifications you are maintaining. In the passband, you are maintaining minimum gain of delta P. But what's happening here is your transition band is becoming narrow, right? Earlier your transition band is Fs minus Fp. Now your transition band is, if you call it like Fs dash, Fs dash minus Fp. Fs dash minus Fp is smaller than Fs minus Fp, right? It means your transition band is becoming narrow. That's good for you, right? But if you try to make this like new Fs dash, where Fs dash equals to 10, for example, at this point, then your transition band will be a bit wider compared to your required specification, right? That is bad actually. If you want, you can try to decrease the transition band. You should not increase the transition band gap. That should be as small as possible. We can try to find omega c in two ways. One way is, as we already know, what is n, this order of the filter. We can substitute into this pass band gain expression and we can get what is omega c from here. Or we can substitute this into this stop band expression, that n value, and we can get back omega c. There are two ways, right? But we'll try to prefer to this one. The reason for this one is we don't want to disturb pass band specifications at all. We want to retain the same specifications in the pass band. That means we want in the pass band, the gain should be above delta P always. We want to maintain 0 to Fp, same 0 to Fp interval. We want to maintain at least gain of delta P. We want to retain as it is. In the stop band, if you want, you can try to reduce the stop band cutoff frequency, but we should not increase the stop band cutoff frequency. So we'll try to make use of this stop pass band gain expression to compute omega c, because we already know what is n, right? Everything is known for it in this. Omega p is known for it, nb is known for it, only unknown thing is omega c. From here you can compute omega c, right? Here we are not disturbing passband specifications, even if actual n is non-integer. If actual n is non-integer, then stop band cutoff frequency will become smaller due to this one, nb greater than n. Actually, order of the filter is some 3.1, for example. But now you are increasing the order. You can think, right? By default, if you keep on increasing the order of the filter, what's happening is you'll get good filter compared to that lower order, right? By default. You can think about it intuitively. The transition band will become narrower. If you want, you can cross-check with some examples. If you make use of this vector omega c and this vector nb to compute what is the updated omega s, is updated omega s. You can equate to stop band gain this expression. From here you can get omega s dash, which will be smaller than omega s. That's good for you. There's no problem at all. Once you know what is omega c and what is n, you can simply have the transfer function, right? It's a transfer function. You can substitute omega c and n value into this one. N means nb here. It's a Chebyshev filter design. Chebyshev type 1 low pass filter. Type 2 Chebyshev also there. In type 1, you are going to get ripples in the pass band. There are no ripples in the stop band, right? In the type 2, there won't be any ripples in the pass band. There will be ripples in the stop band in the type 2. Here also you can see, right? At the order of the filter, it keeps on increasing. that's trying to approach to ideal filter behavior. At the end of the filter is increasing. Let's go to specifications. Here also same thing. This is a passman. 0 to FP hedges, this is the passman. In the passman, we want to maintain at least delta P gain. You can see this. See delta P. This gain is always above delta P, right? Always above delta P in the passman. In the stop band, gain should be less than or equal to delta S. At max, delta S, right? In the stop band gain. Beyond FS, we are calling it like a stop band. You can see this. You can start this part. See, always less than delta S, right? This gain in the stop band. And this is called as transition band. Between pass band, this FP and FS is the transition band. We can have narrow transition band for Chebyshev filters as compared to Butterworth filters. For the same order, if you consider n equal to 5 in both cases, for example, then for Chebyshev filters, we are going to get narrow transition band. That means it's good, right? Chebyshev filter performance is a little bit better compared to Butterworth filter performance. But complexity of design is a bit high for Chebyshev filters. That mathematical compression, that will be a bit tough. The magnitude response of Chebyshev filter type 1. And the transfer function for the Chebyshev low pass filter for n even and for n odd. Either the unknown parameters for us are epsilon and n. If you know what is epsilon and if you know what is n, we can have this transfer function. Chebyshev low pass filter design for given specifications. These are the given specifications in the pass band. It's a pass band cutoff frequency. It means that from 0 to omega p, we should maintain at least delta p gain. The stop band specification, it means beyond omega s, the gain should be less than or equal to delta s. The gain should be at max delta s. The stop band specification. If you are able to find what is n and what is epsilon in this, we are done with design, right? We can try to compute epsilon using this expression. Epsilon with the help of this expression. Because at omega p, the gain should be equal to delta p, right? You can simply substitute omega p into this expression. This will be 1, right? Cn square of 1. Cn square of 1 is 1. Cn of 1 equals to 1. It means this is 1 by root 1 plus epsilon square. 1 by root 1 plus epsilon square equals to delta p. It's a pass band gain. From here, you can find what is epsilon. It's an unknown thing, right? We can compute epsilon from here. And in order to compute the order of filter, you can simply equate stop band gain. It's a stop band gain, right? Stop band gain expression. From here, you can try to compute n. It's an expression for that one. Once again, same thing. The reason for going to ceiling is this need not be integer always. This can be some fraction. You'll try to round off this to upper integer value. Because if you go for lower value, performance will become poor as compared to given specifications. We want to maintain at least the given quality, right, in the specifications. That's why you'll go for upper roundup instead of lower roundup. Once you know what is NC and what is epsilon, and you can have a transfer function straight away, right? The transfer function of Chebyshev low pass filter. Once you know what is epsilon and what is N, you can simply substitute into this expression. Omega P already given in the expression, right? In the specification itself, omega P.